Talisi. Enjoy!
I see a dredging machine, sucking things up from the lake bed. It's really messy.
It's also a death sentence for the lake.
this blight. It is this... Oh, it is you. I thought I was alone. My mother Nawu could retreat here after her many arguments. Before the Sky People's blight hung over this area. Since she stopped coming here, she has become worse. Always so angry. When I tried to confront her on this, our talk grew into a screaming match. She will not even listen to me. Our people barely tolerated her before. But now, she may be too much for even the Olo Ektan to handle. It will put a stain on my entire family.
This place kept her calm?
I have no idea. I only want her to have it back. But the Sky People's putrid clouds render it lifeless.
It's pollution from their machines. They need to be shut down.
It is corruption. An ugly word for an ugly thing. An equally ugly Sky People structure is near, spewing its filth into the air. If you clear this corruption here, maybe then my mother will go back to only slightly annoying everyone. Have you found the source of the Sky People's decay? I hope it is easily dealt with.
Let's go, Telixi!
There, that must be it.
Yank out the cables from the drill arm first, to give the lake a reprieve.
Nobody's sneaking up today.
heard how you ran here, Vefilu. With such rage, the Sky People have become bolder, it seems. Going off on their own, thinking they own this place. I do not wish to see them ever again. I heard how you ran here, Vefilu, with such rage on your heels.
Someone help me here. We had to take this place back, Mother.
The way the others described it, you were ready to fight all the Sky People on your own. Anyway, I am just glad you are all right. I noticed the filth brought by the Sky People has subsided. Must be your doing.
You're Nawo? Vefilu came here to help you.
How? By rushing headlong into the Sky People's deathly air? As if there is not enough to worry about already.
I wanted to know what drew you to this place.
This place brings me balance, peace and quiet, away from our people. I know they find my words too harsh at times, my manner too blunt. I do not need your help, daughter. I have only ever wanted your understanding.
It does not matter what I can give you, Mother. How many more chances will Katnut give you? Before you deemed intolerable and shunned again from Home Tree. Before you are shut out of our lives. Tahewu and I, we need you. Do not do that to yourself. Please, not again.
This area was once heavy with pollution, right? Now it's beautiful. Lots of things can be...
How does this place work anyway?
I would quiet myself here, and then release my frustrations to the winds. When I felt the lightness in my heart. It meant those sorrows were...
Itu is the boldest track.
My favorite, Sarentu. I never thanked you for helping me investigate that strange sound.
Oh, no need. Just glad to help.
Not so fast. The sound has returned, and with it, the children at their questions. Leitao, you said the sound would go away.
Again? I can take another look. Still the same spot?
Yes, the hills nearby. But at night. Always at night.
What if we can't find the source of the sound this time?
The children's curiosity is endless. They swarm around me, like Kinglor. Only they are less fuzzy. And somehow more tiring. But if we adults demand they respect our words, then we must also show them our words are worth respecting. The sound. Have you found it?
Not yet. I'll find it.
Hello? Please come.
That sound. There.
Thank you.
Is that Nilmav?
This place is forbidden. Why have you come?
The children have been hearing strange noises at night.
You, Sarantu, and your inescapable curiosity, like the jaws of a prowling Thanator. It is this instrument, a gift from a Kamatere musician years ago. I am an old man, but even I can sense the light of curiosity fading from all Oronahe, the further we are mired in our own affairs. So, I picked up this dusty instrument to remind myself there is a world outside of Oronahe traditions, to rekindle my own curiosity, as silly as that may seem.
But why the secrecy?
Young one, I know what the others say about me when I am not around. Nirnan, the stuffy, cantankerous elder who balks at everything. Perhaps this is who I am meant to be. This instrument will be shelved away once more, with all my efforts reduced to a strange noise that terrifies the children at night.
You said you felt that curiosity slipping from your people. Maybe your curiosity would inspire others somehow.
Yes, I never thought of it this way. I still have a few tricks to show the rest of my people. If I am to inspire young and old alike, I must not be afraid to show this side of me. Of course! My young friend, you are right indeed. I will not wait to show the Oronahe this side of Nirnan.
You have returned again. Any good news this time?
Nilnan is the one making that sound. He's practicing a new instrument from another clan.
Ah, child. I know the Sarantu are gifted storytellers. But this is taking it too far, yes?
He hopes to master the instrument and share it with the rest of the clan when he's ready.
Oh. You are being serious. Nian, it was a horrid sound, just so we are clear. I will admit, I am quite impressed by the old man's resolve. Perhaps I have been too harsh on him in the past. Now the children can rest easy, and so can I, awaiting Nian's entertainment.
But what else? Wu'an must have been taken by surprise. But what else? A fight happened here. Must be Wu'an's bow. Snapped. Maybe she ran? Viper wolves attack. Broke Wu'an's bow. So she ran. Could follow the scent of herbs?
Oh.
You must be Wu'an. Neitu sent me. She was worried about you.
Neitu is always worried about me. Except she was right this time. I am trapped here.
Trapped? By what?
Viper wolves. With strange markings and no kuru. An unnatural kind.
Unnatural?
Not of Ewa. They are faster than other viper wolves. Nina. It is not hunger or fear that drives them, but I saw sorrow in their eyes. They caught me off guard, snapped right through my bow. They are looking for me. I can hear their prowling. Oh, the horrors they must have endured to turn so vicious. Did the Sky People do this to them? They have no peace, no calm, only the hunt.
If they have your scent, maybe I can catch them unaware.
Perhaps, but give them the mercy of a swift death. Only then will they finally be reunited with Ewa. The poor beasts deserve that kindness, at least. Surround you. Unnatural beasts!
No Kuru. Should take a closer look. Focus. Hajir, I just came across something strange. An animal, but it didn't have a Kuru. Hajir? You there?
No Kuru. You sure? You absolutely sure?
You know something about this?
Come see me in HQ. Hurry.
Do not let them surround you. Stay back, you unnatural beasts. You are back.
You're safe now. The threat is gone.
Oh! I thought I was going to die alone in this place. I can hold myself in a fight, but there is a reason I hunt berries instead of beasts.
I'm sure you could have handled them all if you still had your bow.
Oh, that is sweet of you. I will make sure Netu sets something special aside for you. A token of my gratitude. You are not useless, Netu. Ah, it is you. I have told Netu all about your heroics.
Yes. It sounds like those viper wolves gave you quite a fight.
I asked Netu for something to thank you with. The finest piece of Aranahe clothing.
Wu-An exaggerates my skill. My weaving leaves a lot to be desired.
Thank you. I'll treasure it.
Great. Now you're both exaggerating.
What fruits might this storm shake loose?
Her mother's... simply cannot take a joke. The weather finally matches Leta's temper.
Tell me, do you hunt well?
Not coming. Should be where Nawuk saw that lone human. But what else? Thank you. No. Don't think so. No. Doesn't look right. Doesn't look right. Someone from the Resistance was here, not RDA. Good. Maybe it's linked to... Someone ran. Fast. So fast they dropped their tablet. I wonder if... Whoever was here... They kicked the tree. Brought down the hive. Not smart. Let's see. A Resistance human flew here to work on something, and kicked the tree. Frustrated, maybe? Tablet could have more.
Like the moon. They're bright and round and clearous. And your smile, it's... Well, it's a smile, all right. Ugh. This is so stupid. Say what's on your mind. Cut the artsy crap and be honest. Here goes. You're... Great? No, you're amazing. And everyone can see that. But to me, you're amazing in a way that makes me feel... Wait, what's that?
Alex might know who owns this tablet.
I will make sure we are ready for it.
I should have asked Danny how to hold a gun.
Heard Jake was kicking ass again.
Well, you know he would be, being full-time Navi now, living that blue life.
That has to feel wild. Leaving the body you were born with for good, swapping for a whole new one.
We were so... Hey, what do you got for me?
A tablet I found, dropped by one of our people. Do you think you can fix it?
Ouch. Wish I could say yes. But what this tablet needs is a prayer, not a scientist. You said it belongs to someone in the Resistance?
Yeah. Human, based on the boot prints I found nearby, and female, judging from the audio recording I snagged from it. They made a point to record in privacy, away from HQ.
A human female. Well, that narrows it down. Good luck.
Any idea who might own that broken tablet?
They went out to record alone. So someone bold and proud, maybe too proud for their own good, if they value privacy over personal safety.
Any idea who might own that broken tablet?
They went...
Anka, have you been out in the rainforest recently?
Well, yeah. I'm a pilot. I go out all the time. Gotta keep an eye on those RDA patrols, you know?
Any chance you dropped a piece of gear or tech the last time you went out?
What? No way. Only way I could do that is if I'm literally dropping a tablet from the cockpit or something.
Why did you say tablet when I mentioned missing gear? I didn't say tablet.
Just the first thing that popped in my head. I don't know.
Were you thinking of this tablet?
Where in the hell did you get that?
An Arana I had gathered pointed me to where you dropped it.
What did you find on it?
I recovered some audio. Was that you?
Shit. We do not talk about this here. Follow me. It's embarrassing. I went to that spot specifically so no one would have to be subjected to my nonsense. How much did you hear, anyway?
All of it? I won't tell anyone.
Oh, all of it. That's great. I know the wasps didn't take too kindly to my poem. Ugh, why did I go to that spot in the first place? Real rookie business. What was I thinking?
I guess you were thinking about love.
I'm not exactly the best when it comes to talking about these feelings or whatever. Just really wanted a place away from all the noise to digest all this. You know the saying, love makes dumbass people do dumbass things, right? A good nothing that all did. Even without the RDA and these fun, tense times we live in, do you know how hard it is to try to be romantic here? I can't pick flowers without half of them trying to kill me.
Maybe I can help.
No, look, I appreciate the gesture and all, but let's not. I tried to get all mushy and ended up kicking the hornet's nest. Or a literal wasp's nest. Hive. Same thing. So forget it. I'll move on. I'm good at this sort of thing. Now the RDA knows we're a real force to be reckoned with.
Hey there. Visitors. Thanks for coming. The animal you found? With no Kuru? They're called Ferals. RDA captured them. Removed their Kuru. It was unbelievably cruel.
Why would anyone do such an awful thing?
To control them. Didn't work, of course, just made them suffer. Made them impossible to tame. And I was a part of it. My greatest shame. Now they kill without reason. That's why I left the RDA. But I couldn't save them.
We have to put a stop to it. Give them a merciful death.
Yes. Do the right thing. In larger numbers, they'll wreck the ecosystem. Anka mentioned seeing some strange activity on one of her flights. Could be Ferals. I will send you the coordinates. I am sorry it has come to this.
What'll it be today? Keep yourself in one piece.
Do you think people have started to forgive me? I hope so.
Whatever comes next, I will make sure.
Come to gear up? Remember, point away from the user.
Thank you.
found one. Looks quite ripe and healthy.
Excellent. Look for more, please. The more good quality samples, the better.
Oh, no. Can't focus. Can't focus. Can't focus. Can't focus. Alex? Something's wrong out here.
What do you mean?
Feels like someone's watching me.
I don't like this. Think you better get out of there. I mean it.
Thank you.
Alex? Seems like this survey area is also a Vanator den.
What? A Vanator? Are you injured?
I'm fine. Even got a few samples for you. We'll tell you everything back at the HQ.
I'm not sure how to make it up to everyone.
You were right. A Thanator den? Well, a remote location, no pollution whatsoever. Of course it had to be potentially occupied by some dangerous wildlife. And I've sent you there without a heads up. Stupid! Almost got you killed.
And I've only got a few samples for you. Wish I could have gathered more.
Don't worry. If the samples are good enough, the data from them will still be sufficient. And now that we know that this is a dangerous territory, this knowledge will save lives. You know, people died exploring and studying Pandora. Some of them I knew very well. And they could have done so much more. I need to do better when considering the risks. People trust me when I send them out there. I must prove it's worth it. The samples you've collected will contribute into that.